Hi, Jim Beckler with the RV Corral. Welcome to our website. Thanks for taking a few minutes of your time to look at a fifth wheel with me. I'd like to show you a brand new 2016 Montana High Country. Now, this is actually a new floor plan for Montana. It's a front lounge. We'll take a look when we go inside. You can see it has a pretty unique floor plan. That's called a 374 model. And an FL, you know, standing for front lounge. Of course, Montana is built by Keystone. We really like Keystone products. We carry Montanas, Cougars, Hideouts, Fusion. I mean, we carry four different lines with Keystone. We put a lot of value in their product because they do have a lot of product for the money. They're a good bang for the buck, and they're a reputable company, been doing this for a long time. Other thing I like about Keystone is the fact they only do towables, so they don't delve in motorhomes and try to do a little bit of everything. They just focus on what they do best. And the Montanas and the Cougars have been the two best-selling fifth wheels on the market for a lot of years now. Good quality, like I mentioned. I like the front cap, has this contour, makes it a little easier for maneuvering. You know, it has a good turning radius. Front pin sticks out a ways to kind of help in that too. Even has a little light up front here. If you take a look here, you can see they've come up with a system like that they've actually patented, and it's gives you the ability to look in your rear view mirror when you're backing up your truck, and you can see the reflection of your fifth wheel hitch coming in to mate up to the hitch pin. So that makes it nice. You don't have to turn your head around and try and see if you're hitting the right spot. Just look in your rear view mirror. Good storage up front. You have a lot of storage in this fifth wheel. You can see your power cords in there. This is 50 amp service, so you got a lot of power coming into your coach. It gives you the opportunity to run lots of systems without having to worry about not having enough juice. Got a spot here for a battery. We actually make sure you have two batteries before this thing goes out of here. We're going to put a couple batteries in it for you. Let's take a look over here for just a second. This typically, this side of your RV is the utility side. This is the work side. It's got a nice pass-through storage. And your hookups for your water and everything are right in here. And what makes it nice is it's all enclosed, so you do, it's not exposed to the weather. Now, these are really insulated well. This is a unit you can use year-round and be comfortable in. But I do like the fact that your hookups are right inside of here. You can run your hoses up through here. Even has a little battery disconnect switch right here. Can winterize your coach from right in here as well. If you take a look over here, inside of this compartment is the control panel for your level system. So it has auto level, just like you have on the big motorhomes. So it's just a matter of push button. When you get to where you're setting up camp, you can just hit that auto level and it all does the work. It does all the work for you. It has 6-point level system. You can see you got leveling on the front. You come around the back here. You have one behind your rear wheels and then one in front of your front axles. So it's 6 contact points. It makes it really nice. You even have an entry door on this side of this coach, which is nice. Back part of the coach has a little storage compartment. Plug in for your power cord. You can see it has a nice glossy finish also. Ladder to get up on top. This does have a one-piece fiberglass, or not fiberglass, but rubber roof. Has more storage over here. So as you walk around the unit, you can see that it's got lots of outside storage. Big awning, patio awning, you can see runs almost the whole length of your patio area here, in between your two slides. That's all electric too, so there's no hassling with trying to get your awning out. Just push the button and away you go. Let's take a look inside. So I mentioned out there, it does have a front lounge. So this is a little different than maybe a lot of the floor plans that you've seen. Makes it really homey. This has a nice residential feel, and it gives you a good separation of space. So, you know, this would be the area where you might be spending most of the time just hanging out up in the front. You can see you got good storage here too. Nice size TV, even has a sound bar. It has a nice electric fireplace that is actually a heater as well, so you can use this for electric heat. So if you're plugged in somewhere, you can run that and keep your this area all nice and warm without having to have your furnace on. As you can see, lots of storage up front here too. Everywhere you look, you've got storage compartments, two sofas, and a nice little couple of theater chairs over there that are recliners also. I think both of these are making into beds. This will be this makes into a sleeper, as well as the other sofa. So you got a couple of beds up here. Nice air conditioner right here with a quick cool feature. You can actually open this up and get a little bit more air right in this area if you prefer to cool this area down. It is all ducted. I mean, the air conditioning is going to push air all the way through your coach. You can see the vents in the top. As we go downstairs, back down, we can see, I like this little shelf here too, a great place to maybe put a few knickknacks when you're out set up somewhere. It does have a little shelf here also. Even has a little light, couple lights. There's a little light down in here. Again, you could use that for display. Drawers. You could use this for a little pantry area. Nice residential style table and chairs. Little storage underneath the seat covers. Big window in here too. This lets in a lot of natural light. Notice you do have a large refrigerator in this too. You got a nice four-door refrigerator. This is gas and electric, so it'll operate off of either or. You know, a lot of the manufacturers now are using the all-electric. They don't give you the option on the propane side of the refrigerator, but this one does. So if you dry camp, some people like that idea. Notice all the counter space. Got a nice kitchen area, plenty of counter space. You know, up on the sofa there where the sink covers, so there's two sink covers, so this whole area here could be used for counter space if you're wanting to utilize that. This area here also, a nice little residential faucet with a sprayer. They do use a nice solid surface material on the countertops. And again, tons of storage. So Montana is really designed for more of a residential application. So these are the kind of units that people are going to get into that want to spend some time on the road. Maybe be a more full-time or even snowbird, or you know, people buy these too that just buy something they want to live in for a while. And you know, you've got a nice gas oven here, three burner stovetop, lots of drawers. Notice these are all full extension drawers too, with nice metal glides, so they're heavy duty. They operate nice and smooth, and you can put some weight on them, and they're not going to pop out of there. So you can don't have to worry about those things falling out. Has controls right here, easy to get to for your heating and air conditioning. Does have the fantastic fan vent, max van, I guess they call on this one here, in your galley area, which is really nice. That moves a lot of air. You have control right here for that too. As we go back into the bedroom area, I mentioned it has a good separation. So as you come back here, you can see you've got a nice bathroom area, nice big bathroom. huge shower with the little seat. Skylight lets in a lot of natural light. It's all ducted too, with air conditioning and heat in here. Nice little sink with additional storage underneath. Nice large compartment down there, and a nice medicine cabinet, little shelves. And right behind you here, as you spin around, you can see the commode, but it also has a spot right there where you could, it's plumbed in there for washer and dryer. So if you did want to have a washer and dryer, you can put that right in the compartment, or just use it for storage. Nice big storage area. As we go into the bedroom, you can see that you can access from your bedroom side to this compartment. Having said that, let's take a look back here. So here's what I was talking about, that compartment back here you can get to from here, and in your bathroom area even has a 110 plug, which is nice. Huge amount of storage actually. And down here again, a lot of storage here. You can see that it has a 110 plug, and then there's your hookup for your washer and dryer. If you decided you wanted to have a you could use a combo washer and dryer set right in there. King size bed. Notice you do have windows on both sides too, which is nice. A lot of people like the idea that you can have some windows on the side of your bed, open those up, get a little ventilation. Look at all that storage underneath there. A huge storage compartment. You do have storage up above your bed as well. And the closet's a nice little layout. Even has a little couple of shelves back here. Shelf up above. And just a good looking layout. It's really real pleasant decor in this one. Already has a TV in the back here. I like this idea here too. You got a little laundry basket right here. You can drop things in there for your laundry. Nice drawers that slide out. But if you start looking around, you can see there's a lot of 110 outlets, because these are designed with a little bit more of a residential feel. You know, they're a good unit that you can spend some time in and be comfortable. Lots of lights, lots of plug-ins, lots of storage, good capacities for your fresh water, all the things that really add up and make it a more comfortable experience if you want to spend some time out on the road for a while. So I'd be glad to tell you a little bit more about it. Please just get a hold of me. You can reach me at 541-510-1017, and again, my name is Jim Beckler. So ask for me, please, and I will be glad to help. Thank you.